Congratulations on your new HPGen system. In this short video, we will guide you through the basic steps of installation. First of all, there are a few safety considerations. 1. No power should be connected before the installation is completed. 2. The unit should be electrically grounded through the power cable. 3. Remember to carefully follow installation instructions, and in case of any doubt, please contact support at HPNow. For the installation site, please consider the following requirements for successful operation. Clean, potable water input. Suitable power capacity. Note that power consumption depends on the HPGen model purchased, so confer with your pre-installation checklist. An exclusive electrical circuit to provide power to the system at all times. Access to clean air, free of particles from, for example, diesel generators. GSM reception for internet connectivity. In case of poor GSM connectivity, please consider an Ethernet cable for internet access without a firewall. Now we will go through an overview of the HPGen system, which overall consists of four parts. In the top, an electrical drawer handles control, power supply, user interface, and IoT connectivity to HPNow. Below the drawer are oxygen concentrators for oxygen delivery to the electrochemical cells. Underneath is the electrochemical stack, which combines water, oxygen, and electricity to produce the peroxide ultra-pure solution. Finally, in the bottom, a water pre-treatment system supplies deionized water to the electrochemical stack. The HPGen is designed to operate automatically based on peroxide demand. The system works with an external peroxide reservoir and produces depending on its filling level. HPGen starts producing peroxide when the reservoir is close to empty and stops producing once the reservoir is full. Application of the peroxide ultra-pure solution is simple. With a dosing pump connected to the reservoir, peroxide ultra-pure solution can be injected into the target water lines with an amount that matches the desired concentration. Overall, there are two simple tasks in the installation of an HPGen system. 1. Preparation of the peroxide reservoir. 2. Connecting water piping to the cabinet. Let us start with preparing the peroxide reservoir in three steps. It should have at least 1 cubic meter in capacity, be clean of particles and foreign metals, and it should be shielded from direct sunlight. The container walls should be of dark color with no openings for dust and metals. Step 1. Drill 3 holes with diameter 22 millimeters in the top part of the reservoir. It is important not to get residual plastic into the reservoir, since it can clog the dosing pump later on. Here, we use a vacuum cleaner to remove the residue while drilling. 1 hole is for ventilation, and the 2 others are for connecting tubing to the HPGen cabinet. Step 2. Now, the bulkhead fittings can be screwed on by holding the nuts with one hand on the inside of the reservoir. For the ventilation hole, insert a little assembly of fittings to ensure that dust and particles do not fall into the reservoir over time. Remember to close the lid of the reservoir after these steps. Tubing from the HPGen cabinet can now be inserted into the bulkhead fittings. Step 3. For measuring the level of peroxide solution in the reservoir, we install a pressure sensor on the sidewall, as close as possible to the bottom of the reservoir. First, drill a hole with diameter 30 millimeters, again making sure not to get plastic residue into the reservoir. Here, we must use a special bulkhead fitting, as shown, which can be screwed in from the outside. Tighten half a turn with a wrench after finger tightening. Now, screw on an adapter fitting, which decreases the diameter, and insert a corner fitting, a short 3/8 inch tube, and finally the pressure sensor part. All these components are included in the HPGen. Mind the wire that is connected to the HPGen cabinet from the pressure sensor. This connection is crucial for proper operation. Having prepared the reservoir, we now turn to connecting the tubing to the back of the HPGen. First, move the pure water tank and DI resin column a little to the side for better access. With the backplate accessible, tubing can be connected. For each connection, start by removing the fitting stoppers by pushing in the ring underneath before pulling out the plug. These plugs are just there for transportation and must be removed before other tubing connections can be made. To insert a tubing in the quick fitting, simply insert the tube all the way and check that it cannot be pulled out again. In the bottom right corner, connect your water source where it says H2O in. Next, connect tubing to the bottom left fitting, labelled RO1, which should be connected to a drain. Now comes the connection labelled HPGen H2O2, which is the output peroxide ultrapure solution. This must be connected to the peroxide reservoir that was prepared with fittings earlier in the video. Finally, there is a connection labelled H2O out, which is excess water flow from the stack. This should also be connected to the peroxide reservoir. For powering the HPGen, we will provide a cable with country-specific plug. Please ensure there is proper grounding installed for the power connection. Here we show a version with CEE 3-phase. The HPGen comes with a GSM SIM card router that can connect to our remote monitoring system worldwide. The router should be connected to a power cable coming from the cabinet. The Ethernet cable from the cabinet should be connected to the left port when looking at the back end of the router. In case GSM connectivity is poor in your location, please connect a firewall-free Ethernet connection to the port on the right-hand side. The router should be placed on top of the cabinet. Now, the system is ready for final commissioning, which should be scheduled with an HPNow support engineer. Please contact us for this step. When powered on, the user interface will load, and after a short while, the screen shows current status, filling level of reservoir, most recent output concentration, and any potential alerts. The HPGen is designed for automated operation and should always be left powered on during normal operation. The on-off switch on the control panel should only be used in two cases. 1. In case of emergency, flip the switch immediately off. 2. In case there is a need to disconnect the HPGen from power for maintenance, follow a controlled shutdown procedure, which can be activated by pressing stop on the control panel. Wait until the display is indicating idle. This can take up to 2 hours. Only then, flip the power switch off. We at HPNow look forward to working with you going forward and remain at your disposal for any service requests.